All right. This is my beloved hexacopter. It doesn't really get much airtime, literally. Mainly because it spends most of its life on its back. It'd make a good wife, to be quite honest with you, the amount of time it's on its back. Don't quote me on that, otherwise I'll be washing dishes for the rest of my life. Right. I've managed to flash the firmware on this thing. It was a real fight to find out how to get it flashed correctly. There's just so many different versions of firmware, of flashing software. There's so many versions of these blackboards, kkboard, flycam boards. You've got 5.5Ds and Es and pluses, and it's just endless the amount of variations of these boards. So it took forever to figure out how to flash his board. I got that one flashed. However, one of the more modern ones that I've got, that's one of them. I've got an even better one than that somewhere, or a later version. That's a 5.5. I've got a 5.5E plus, for goodness sake. And this is a 5.5, and it's different to the way you hook it up to do the firmware, and it uses different firmware. The combinations and permutations are endless of these things. Anyway, cut a long story short, I think I've managed to, I'm pretty confident that I've managed to flash the firmware on this hexacopter, and I have got it in the H6 format this time, whereas before I'm pretty sure it was in the cross, the plus configuration, I should say, where there was a one motor to the front orientation, whereas this time it's definitely in the H6 format. So let's go and configure this one, and I'll go put it in the air or go put it on its back. We'll wait and see. What was that about? Okay. What's going on here? Oh, that made me jump. It did. Whoa. I think you'd better put a crash helmet on. I know I'm going to put one on. Dear me. That was crazy. Made a bid for freedom, that one. Right, so those need to come right down. All right, that that showed potential. Oh, this is going to end in tears. That was on the edge. Alright. I think I've got it. Whoa!
It would have been if it hit the greenhouse.
Why did it do that? It was going okay for a nanosecond. But it likes to flip, I know that. Alright, so I think I found the limit of those two. In bits. Right. Alright, something obviously wrong with it still. I buried. crazy, some of those flips. It was difficult to explain. It was kind of totally out of my hands. It's not exactly what you want. And the more I tried to dial the power down, the more it seemed to increase. So yeah, pretty pleased I didn't take the greenhouse out and or take anything else out. And I'm actually, it's quite durable. It survived survived a few flips. Actually, that's all it's ever done in its life, flipped over. So that's going to come apart and make use of these, I think, 1400 kV flycam motors. I'll probably use them on something, and maybe I was going to do a small hexacopter, but after the way this flew, it sort of put me off doing anything small. Big is better from now on. So there we go. That's my quite a depressing day's testing, to be honest. Could have been out flying. It was a beautiful day, no excuses, no wind, and end result was a big fat flip over, or two, or three, could have even been four. So there we go, that's that one done, and this thing will not be coming out, I wouldn't think, in this format again. It's going to the retirement home for hexacopters, wherever that may be.